I've been talking a lot lately about vitamin D, but I've been neglecting vitamin K2. So this video is on K2. Vitamin K2 is quite amazing. It inhibits vascular and joint calcification. It keeps your joints and your arteries from becoming bone. So vitamin K2, which is a fat-soluble vitamin, activates an inhibitory protein. It's called matrix GLA protein. And so what this protein does is it stops, it's like the brake pads, okay? It stops calcium from forming in the arteries and in your joints. Vitamin K2 also helps form bone. It makes your bones more mineralized, okay? So it makes the bones stronger. Vitamin K2 decreases insulin resistance. Now we know insulin resistance is involved in damaging the arteries that's causing the calcification in the first place, as well as the inflammation in the joints, which is behind arthritis and bursitis and tendonitis. So vitamin K2 is extremely powerful in not just keeping the calcium out of the wrong place, but putting it back in the right place, as well as inhibiting the very root cause of why it's there in the first place. So it's very, very powerful. You want to take vitamin D3 with K2. So if you're going to take 10,000 IUs of vitamin D3, we want K2 at 100 micrograms. Okay, that's the ratio that I would recommend. Now, this is MK7. There's many different types of vitamin K2. This video is not going to be on that topic, but let's talk about what food you should be eating to raise your vitamin K2. Liver, animal liver, which also includes pate right here. Goose pate has some of the highest levels of K2. Fermented foods have vitamin K2, especially natto, which is a Japanese fermented soybean product. Natto has not just MK, and MK is just a version of K2, MK4, MK5, MK6, MK7, and 8. So it has a lot of different types of K2. Grass-fed meat has vitamin K2. Egg yolks have vitamin K2. Hard and soft cheese has the MK4 version, the 5, the 6, the 7, 8, and the 9. Salami has vitamin K2. Make sure you get the version that does not have sugar or dextrose. I found one from the health food store, so that's the one I consume. And sauerkraut has K2. It has a lot of different types, the MK4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. And grass-fed butter has K2. It has the version 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 as well. So it's quite comprehensive. So in summary, you can see how vitally important K2 is for a lot of different things. Thanks for watching. Before you go, if you have a question about a product, or you're new to keto and you want to know how to begin keto, or you're on keto and you need a debug because it's not going as smooth, I have a keto consultant standing by to help you. This is just for the people in the US. Hopefully in the future we'll be able to answer everyone's call. But I put the number down below so you can call and get some help.